Hello, my name is Jeff Sanders. I'm a senior escalation engineer at Microsoft. I support Windows Store Apps, Windows Phone, and Windows Azure Mobile Services. Today I want to talk about ignoring certificate errors in Windows Store Apps. We can do this in versions 8.1 of Windows and later because of the windows.web.http client namespace that's available in the .NET framework. This video blog complements a blog that I've written on MSDN called How to Ignore Self-Signed Certificate Errors in Windows Store Apps. You can find our blogs on the WS Dev Sol alias here on MSDN blogs. So I'll jump right into some coding, some discussion, because we have a limited amount of time here and I want to keep your interest. Let's bring up some code and we'll walk through it. Let me preface this by saying you shouldn't ignore certificate errors. So it may seem odd that I'm actually presenting this, but there are some very limited cases where you may want to ignore certificate errors. The premise is if you are ignoring certificate errors, you're probably undermining the whole SSL security of your application. So you want to be very selective on what you're ignoring. And in this modified sample, it's a little bit different from the text blog. I'll be ignoring a request from this particular issuer. So if the certificate comes from jsanders4.northamericacorp.microsoft.com, I will be ignoring the certificate errors, but for everything else that comes through, I'm going to let the exception happen if it's an invalid certificate. Furthermore, I'll be ignoring very specific errors, so I expect certain errors when I hit this website. The XAML for this code is very simple. I just have an input button click to kick off the operation and then a result. So let's jump into the code and see what's going on. First of all, this using statement here, windows.web.http, allows us to use the HTTP client that's in this namespace. We can't do this with system.net, so this is very important. Furthermore, the filters is what we're going to use to ignore certain errors, and we'll talk about that. Let's briefly cover the setup of the code. I'm creating an HTTP client in my class, my main page, and I'm going to use that for any of the HTTP request calls that I'm going to make over the wire. And then I also have a list of host names that I will ignore, and these are actually issuer names. Here's how I'm going to look up to see where did the certificate come from and should I ignore it? So the constructor on main page, I create my HTTP client used for requests. I'm creating this list and adding this particular issuer to the list. The button click code isn't very interesting. I just go in and call this asynchronous task, which returns a string. It'll be up to you what you return. In my case, I'm just returning a status. You may want to return a bool or a class or something else. The HTTP request message is very simple. We're just simply gonna go and try to hit this URI with a get. We have some other variables that we're going to use up here, including this, which I'll talk about later. In our try block, we try to execute the request. If there were no exceptions, we'll hit this. If there was an exception, we're looking for a very particular exception, which when decoded will be 12045, and that means that there was a certificate error. So if we do get a certificate error, we want to go to the request and get the transport information. Now we don't have the response object here because we've had the request fail with an exception, so that's why the request actually contains the transport information and inside there the server certificate errors. In my case, I'm looking for very specific errors. So if we have an error object and the certificate is expired and it's untrusted, these are two that I expect. And I'm going to look inside of my host names to ignore to find out if the issuer is in that list. And if the issuer is in that list, here's where we use something called the base protocol filter. HTTP client allows you to define filters. It will filter the requests going in and out and do certain actions on them. I'm not going to talk about this here. I'm using the base implementation, which is the base protocol filter, because it contains a list of ignorable certificate errors that I can add to. By default, this thing is empty. What I'm going to do is say ignore expired and ignore untrusted certificate errors. So only for these two errors will I be able to use this base protocol filter and get a successful response. And finally, I set this little bool here saying, yes, I want to retry the certificate errors. So again, I have to meet a bunch of criteria before I'll even retry ignoring the cert errors. It has to be a particular issuer. It has to be particular validation results. Then what I do is I'm temporarily creating a new HTTP client. I'm creating a new one and not using the app-wide one or the page-wide one because this is, again, an exception. We shouldn't ignore all the errors. So I'm creating an HTTP client and putting my base protocol filter into the constructor, which has those overrides for the certificate errors. Then I call, and if I am successful, I know I don't have any certificate errors. So let's run this really quick, and we will test it out. And I'm going to put a breakpoint right here in the response so we can see what's going on. I run the application, I push the button, calls this asynchronous task. We'll step over this, and we'll see if we get an exception. So we take a look at the H result of the exception, and we find out after we strip off the higher order bits if it's a 12.045 or not, and it is. Then we go into the request. Remember, this is the request. We go to the transport information and get the server certificate errors. And this object here contains a count of 2, and we'll see as we come into this test that it is the expired and entrusted ones that we expect. Now again, a further implementation item here may be to see that there's only 2 errors, because there may be additional errors as well. You can see I'm only testing to see if it does have expired and trusted, but perhaps the name could be wrong as well. We'll step over. We do meet this condition. Now we want to test to see if, again, the transport information service certificate issuer is a particular name, and it is as expected. Create our new base protocol filter and add the expired and untrusted flags so we can ignore those two and those two only. Set the retry flag. We retry using a new HTTP client with the base protocol filter that I've defined. And retry that call to URI and get the response. And you'll see we did get from the response a status code 200, which means okay. So again, I hope that you realize the importance of not overriding certificate errors. But in those outside cases, like if you were doing perhaps a debug build and you're hitting an internal server, you could surround this area with a pound if def debug or something like that to ensure only in a very limited set of cases would you ignore those errors. Attached to this blog will be some links about the dangers of ignoring certificate errors, and back to my original blog. I hope you've enjoyed this.